Before breaking at 8 a.m, the death toll from those severe storms striking the east coast has risen. In the last hour, Queensland police confirming they have found the body of one woman who went missing in floodwaters in Gympie. They're still looking for another woman, as a 9-year-old has also been killed in Logan. In Moreton Bay, one person has been killed after a boat capsized in wild weather. Crews right now resuming that search for two people missing. In Victoria, floodwaters have claimed the life of a woman in Gippsland after a man was struck and killed by a falling tree. And this new video from Victoria Police this morning showing the rescue of a woman and her dog from the fast-moving Werribee River. Bailey Kenzie is at Manly Harbour for us this morning. Bailey, good morning again to you. What's the latest on the search efforts there?
Well, Mayor, good morning to you. We're yet to receive an official update from police, but I can tell you we've seen numerous Coast Guard crews and water police crews resume this search and rescue effort here at Moreton Bay. It was around 4 kilometres off to my right, off the coast, where this all unfolded around 5:30 yesterday evening, that boat capsizing with 11 people on board. Now, of those 11 people, 8 of them were located and taken to hospitals across Brisbane. 2 remain outstanding this morning, and 1 person sadly died. It wasn't just at Moreton Bay where tragedy was felt over at Logan. A 9-year-old girl swept up in those storm waters, sadly dying as well. Of course, these mammoth storm cells have left SES crews with a huge clean-up effort.
The State Emergency Service are responding to almost 1,600 calls, so there's a lot of work to be done. Most of those calls are in the southeast corner across Gold Coast, Logan and Scenic Rim. But we're in negotiation and good talks with New South Wales SES, who have come to the party, and they'll be providing some additional support from just south of the border to our SES colleagues to start the clean-up around the Gold Coast.
And Mia, the SES crews, well, they've done a great job. Yesterday, it was 120,000 homes across the southeast corner who were without power. That number today looking a little more like 85,000 homes. But Mia, still so many Queensland families left counting the costs.
They're told more days without power are on the way. Thanks for that, Bailey.
Sad news breaking this morning. World-renowned Australian chef Bill Granger has died at the age of 54. Let's go live to Edward Godfrey, who's outside one of his restaurants in Chelsea, London. Edward, what more do we know?
We are outside one of his restaurants here in Chelsea in London, which was one of a handful that Bill Granger had. And like us, staff here are only just learning that very sad news that the famous Australian chef has passed away at the age of 54. His family have posted on Instagram saying, "It is with great sadness the family announces he died peacefully on Christmas Day, surrounded by his family, a dedicated husband and father. He died peacefully in hospital with his wife Natalie and 3 daughters." The Melbourne-born chef built a career spanning 30 years, taking his food and his skills to the world. In the late 90s, he and his wife launched their business, which resulted in 19 restaurants right around the globe. He wrote more than a dozen books, and he was known for making unpretentious food into something really special. We are starting to see tributes posted online for him, Jamie Oliver among them, saying, "I loved Bill Granger so much. He was a wonderful man who had an extraordinary ease and style in cooking that could only come from Australia." No doubt those tributes will continue to roll in, and it won't just be foodies and industry heavyweights, Nick, feeling this loss. This will be a loss felt by many right around the world.
I couldn't agree more, Edward. I mean, he's such a great Australian and so young to lose his life there. Thank you.
A Sydney household has escaped serious injury after their kitchen went up in flames this morning in the city's northwest. It's believed a fridge sparked the blaze, a fire alarm at the Carlingford home alerting residents, who quickly called 000. A volunteer firefighter has died battling bushfires in the south of Western Australia. He was operating a private firefighting vehicle on his neighbour's farm alongside a crew. 2 areas are still burning out of control through the bush surrounding Esperance.
A major setback for Russia's war in Ukraine, with the country's defence minister this morning confirming one of its warships has been destroyed in an attack on a Black Sea port. One person was killed in the strike in Crimean waters controlled by Russia. President Zelensky and other Ukrainian military leaders have praised the attack.
"This is such a powerful event for us. In fact, we destroyed both the ship and the occupiers through well-coordinated actions."
The extent of the damage to the ship is still not immediately clear. A huge fire has ripped through a guest house in Romania, killing five people, including a child. Video from the scene shows metre-high flames and thick smoke billowing from the building. 26 people are thought to have been in the property when the blaze started. It's been far from a white Christmas in parts of Germany, with heavy rain causing rivers and streams to flood. The wild weather forcing hundreds of people to leave their Christmas Day gathering and seek emergency shelter. Russian opposition leader Alexei Navalny has this morning spoken out for the first time after disappearing for nearly 3 weeks. Navalny posted to X, formerly known as Twitter, saying he was relieved and fine despite an exhausting 20-day transfer to a penal colony beyond the Arctic Circle. The Kremlin critic also joked about him being the new Santa Claus, saying he now has a sheepskin coat and has grown a beard.
Confirmation this morning, the body found at a Western Sydney beach exactly 1 week after it opened is the 35-year-old man who went missing. Today's Jack Hine is at Penrith Beach. Jack, you've just learned the gates will remain closed today.
Yeah, that's correct, but the news really isn't filtering through to the public yet. There's no signs on this 80-kilometre stretch of road. Within the last 10 minutes, we've had three vehicles fly into this driveway and get a rude shock discovering the media here and the gates are closed. The state government department that runs this beach has confirmed the beach will be closed today, given that a 35-year-old lost his life in the water yesterday. Nine News understands that the St Mary's man was paddleboarding when he got into trouble outside of the patrol zone about 2 o'clock yesterday, and by 6 p.m. police made the grim discovery. This morning we're being reminded to take extra care in the waterways this summer.
As people head off for their holidays, traditionally this is the busiest time on waterways. We've had, you know, forecasts of more heavy storms, and flooding will be a significant issue, and hot weather just means many people will be flocking to waterways, rivers, lakes and also beaches. We'd urge people to watch their children constantly around water.
A report into this tragedy will be handed to the coroner, Nick.
Thanks, Jack.
As Melbourne's housing crisis hits all-time highs, the state government is reaching to the skies. A high-density Japan-style makeover now set in place for several suburbs. Nine Melbourne reporter Kiara Parker is live from Cheltenham for us, one of the affected suburbs by all of this. Kiara, morning again to you. The developments will be focused around the train lines.
Yeah, these Japan-style high-rise developments planned for Melbourne will be focused around train stations. The state government is set to take control of vast areas of Melbourne. High-rise developments earmarked for an area 24 times the size of Docklands as part of the controversial suburban rail loop project. 45 square kilometres of land will be rezoned to increase density around train stations from here in Cheltenham to Box Hill. Two precincts around Clayton and Monash University will be merged to create a mega urban renewal area. Residents impacted by these towers are concerned how it'll affect their communities. Take a listen.
I'd prefer your own property, your own space, but with the housing crisis at the moment, it's kind of the most approachable way, I guess, for providing housing for everyone.
You can't just whack buildings anywhere you like. There needs to be community consultation. They need to talk to the people and understand where the best place for these sort of buildings is.
Well, I think it's a good idea, especially with the work they're doing on the train lines, get people closer to those. But at the same time, we need to make sure our roads are being upgraded.
So these Japan-style high-rises are, of course, to deal with Melbourne's housing crisis and our rapid population growth set to hit 9 million people by 2050. Mia?
That's a lot of people. Kiara, thank you.
It is a lot of people. 9 million makes you want to go overseas, and that's what plenty of people will be doing. And they could soon have cheaper airfares. Qantas, Singapore Airlines and Thai Airways are among those looking to add more flights in the coming months, with capacity still behind pre-pandemic times by 500,000 seats. Turkish Airlines is also looking to enter the market, all of which could push prices down by over 10%. Fingers crossed. Well, this next story is pretty cool. Australia will make history next year when our first locally made rocket blasts off from a commercial facility in Queensland. Company Gilmore Space is now waiting on final approval to launch its sovereign orbital system named Eris on board their 25-metre and high 30-tonne rocket. All going well, takeoff will take place in 2-3 months.